Hey guys, Hector here from strongasthect.com in this week's workout of the week. Today we're going to be continuing with our kettlebell swing series. Last week we went over the two-handed swing and we even did the workout in a ladder protocol. So every set changed. We did 3, 5, 7, 9 and then we repeated that for 10 to 15 minutes depending on how much time you had available to you. So we're gonna be continuing that series, but today we're gonna be focusing on the one arm swing or the one-handed swing, whatever you wanna call it, same exact thing. But we're gonna be doing straight sets today. What is a straight set? A straight set compared to the ladder is you're gonna be doing the same number of repetitions every single week, every single set, not every single week, you're gonna be doing the same repetitions every single set for a period of 10 to 15 minutes. So we're gonna be continuing with this theme of 10 to 15 minute workout. So crazy busy person, right? Got kids, but yet you're still struggling to kinda get in a good workout, get stronger, lose some weight, fit better in your clothes. This little series that we're gonna be continuing with is really going to help out and really give you a really good workout. So we're gonna be focusing on the one-handed swing today. Now, one of the things that I want you to focus on when you're going through these swings is we're going to be doing one-handed swing. At the top of the swing, your free hand, the non-working arm, I want you to touch the handle. Just gently touch the handle with your non-working arm. What that's going to do is that's going to help you to keep your shoulder square at the top, because when you're swinging a bell with one hand, the bell has a tendency to kind of want to turn your body. Okay, it's going to try to create this rotational torque. Okay, many people do this on guard position where you kind of have your arm up like that. That's a phenomenal cue. I highly encourage you to do that if that's what feels comfortable for you. But I like to kind of have my hand open and relatively close to the handle in my hand. Why is that? Because I just like, it's hand-eye coordination thing for me. I like to be able to, if I needed to, is hand switch nice and smooth if I needed to. So with my background in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, I have this philosophy that the way that you train is the way that you'll compete. Okay, the way that you do, right, it's kind of like the way that you do anything is the way that you'll do everything. Right? So it's all the smallest details that count. So the way that you train is the way that you're going to compete. So if I train like this, I'm kind of doing sloppy swings, then when it comes time to, and I'm practicing that way, when it comes time to train, in this sense, competing, training, it's going to show up. Okay, so I like to build those really good habits of always having my hand ready. That way, when it comes time to actually swing and switch, my hand is within about 5 to 6 inches of a really quick hand transfer. Okay, so that's why I like to have my hand open and relatively close to the bell. You can definitely use this on guard position. Great cue. Good for helping keeping the shoulder squared. You definitely want to find what works best for you. But I want you to focus on touching the handle with your free hand. So we're gonna be doing sets of 11 and your rest period will be to the top of the minute, okay? If you're doing the one arm swing, you're gonna want to switch hands every set. So you're not gonna do 11, swing, switch, 11, okay? That would be 22 swings and it can be kind of challenging to maintain that power, that same power from rep number 1 all the way to rep number 22 in the same set. So we're gonna be breaking it up. It's gonna, you know, preserve your grip and it's gonna make you just stronger overall and it's gonna give you a much more effective training session. So you'll do 11 swings, bell down, shake it out, stay fast, stay loose. At the top of the next minute, you will knock out 11 swings on your other side. So I'm gonna demo both sides. I'm not gonna necessarily rest to the top of the minute just because I want, for time constraints. And I just want you to listen to my breathing, just kind of see how my body's moving, and notice that I'm gonna be touching the bell with my non-working hand, okay? So setup stays the same. Lean the bell back, chest up, shoulder square, touch, okay, there's my 11, I think that was 11. Stay fast, stay loose, shake out your hands, shake out your legs, bounce around. Just try to recover as fast as you can, because 11 swings will take roughly 16 and a half, maybe 17 seconds, depending on how much float that you're getting at the top of the swing. And don't worry too much about getting the bell really high. Just let, you know, shoot for your arm parallel to the floor, okay? You don't want to let your hand come too high, because then you can start to lose tension here in the abs. But you also don't want your swing to be really, really low, because you definitely want to, so because from here, the bell's really not floating. And you really want to get that float to where the bell kind of floats up to about chest level. The bell should make an extension of your fist, okay? Nice straight line from the bell to the fist, wrist, elbow, and shoulder. So now I'm gonna do the other set, the other side, and notice that I'm touching the bell with my free hand, okay? Shoulder square, eyes up, chest up. You got one more. There you have it, 11 per side. Switching hands, okay? Notice my breath was a sharp exhale. You don't have to sharply exhale every single time. I highly encourage that. It's definitely gonna kind of challenge your breathing. It's gonna really get the abs involved. That's power breathing. Now, I'm not saying don't power breathe, but if you don't feel comfortable like actually doing that noise, I guess, you can count forcefully. I like that one too. When you count forcefully, you're still getting the, you're still accomplishing the same task, I guess, because you're getting the abs, diaphragm to kick in and to drive straight down. So an example of counting forcefully would basically look like this. One, two, three, four. See, so you're kind of getting the same thing. But eventually, work up to where you're actually getting that traditional power breath. That way you kind of sound like a boxer every time they're striking the heavy bag, right? You're starting to hear these little movements. That's because they're getting the abs involved behind each and every strike. So that's it for this week's workout of the week. So this workout is from our ebook, Kettlebell Workout Snacks, that take only 10 to 15 minutes to complete. It's a collection of 8 of our best 4-week programs. I've left that and a couple of other additional free resources in the description below. Keep your eyes open also in our blog. I'm going to be writing up about differences between two-handed and one-handed swing, you know, why you would want to do one over the other, what are the benefits of both swings, and just kind of give you a little bit more idea of why you'd want to do one over the other. But this week's workout is focused on the one-handed swing. If you have any questions, if you have any comments, leave it in the comments section below. And one more thing, if you're liking these our workout videos, our technique of the week, our Movement Monday, if you're liking these videos and you want to stay up to date with what it is that we're doing, I highly encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and even check out my blog. I got a lot of free resources that I think you would really dig. So that's all I got for you guys this week. Again, I'm Hector with strongasheck.com, and this week's workout of the week.